Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the webinar series Symposium. Today, we'll be talking about the topic, the dual degrees and the various options that SME provides. So here we have with us our faculty, Dr. Agarwal, and I'll give a brief introduction about him. So he has been a faculty member in IT and the analytics sector, a senior subject matter expert. He has been a lead business analyst, consultant, and a research fellow in India and abroad in well-known organizations. So he has also received various awards and fellowships by DAAD, the European Commission, Government of Canada, Swiss Government, Irish Research Council, Microsoft Inc., and much more. So he has also published various articles in IT and have also appeared in informal journals of computing, IEEE Trans on Neural Networks, IEEE Trans on Data and Knowledge Engineering, IEEE Trans on Systems, Man Cybernetics, on Fuzzy Systems, and also International Journal of Machine Learning and Cybernetics. He is also the chairperson of the International Relations at SMEIT Jodhpur, and he has been a super support to all the dual degree aspirants in making this process so seamless and hassle-free. So without further ado, I would request Professor Manish Agarwal to address the audience. The virtual floor is all yours, sir.
Oh, thank you very much, Subhadip. And so today I would like to give you the salient aspects of the dual degree program at our school. And as the name suggests, so the dual degree program at SMEIITJ offers the students distinct advantages, which are one of its own kind in the country. So the first advantage, as the name suggests, it's a dual degree. So in the same time, you are getting two degrees, and both the degrees are very much well known, established around the world from the prestigious institutions. So under dual degree program, you would be getting an MBA degree from IIT Jodhpur School of Management, and at the same time, in 2 years, you would also be getting another degree, that is MS or MA from one of the partner institutes. So you have a wide range of options to choose that the degree which you wish to get, and as per your career aspirations, as per your goals. And so that is one of the foremost advantage, that you are getting two degrees. So you are getting a business degree, that is MBA, at the same time you are also getting a technical degree, that is MS. And so you know much more that today the companies or your startup environment, they need they don't need just managers, but they need techno manager, so somebody who knows the technical skills, who is good in the technology, because technology, without technology, everything is handicapped. So COVID has been a big an educator for us, like COVID experience, and so it has further fostered the need of technology. And you see daily the articles which are coming, which is further bringing this point home, that what industry requires and what the world requires now is a strong skills in technology, supplemented with the managerial skills. So so this is a very win-win situation which the dual degree program offers. And the degree programs which we have chosen are very much contemporary and perhaps ahead of the time. So you will see shortly when I would take you through the details of it. And that is one thing. Another thing is you are also getting a very significant discount on the your education expenses at the foreign partner institute. So if you go directly without IITJ for solo degree, like if you go for only MS degree and approach these institutes, the fees may be higher by the order of 30 to 35%. So that way you are getting that another advantage. Thirdly, the admission criteria is very much relaxed if you are an IITJ student, and 99% you can expect to get admission if you are applying for a dual degree program through IITJ. So, and you have relaxed admission criteria as compared to your direct admission if you try on your own. So these are crisply, these are the advantages which IITJ offers you under the dual degree program. So I will take you some more details. I will just share my screen and so you can get. So I hope my it is visible to you, or?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay, the full screen mode.
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay. So first I will talk about our association with the State University of New York at Albany Business School. So as I said, under this program, MBA would be offered by School of Management at IITJ, and MS degree in digital forensics and cybersecurity is offered by the State University of New York. And so total duration for this dual degree program is 2 years. And to give you some idea about this program, there were more than 150,000 jobs on offer till the pandemic struck. And almost what I have understood from our foreign university that there is 100% absorption of students in the industry after doing this program. And the salary which they get is of the order of 150 to 160,000 US dollars per annum. So that is what I have understood. So very much in demand, and that was the situation before COVID. And in my opinion, after this COVID, the cybersecurity professionals demand have only increased. It has not decreased. So that is evident from the different kind of experience we all face as individuals, and the reports which we are getting in the media. So this program is was very much in demand till the pandemic struck, and it's very likely that the situation would be good for this program after the pandemic for you, like if you go for it. And so it has three themes, this course at Sunny Albany. So it will cover cybersecurity, digital forensics, and cyber operations. So which are inseparable from any management business. No? So, and you will get specialized knowledge. So it's an MS degree. So you are getting a complementary knowledge. So you will be learning about your MBA courses in the first year, along with your peers, along with your classmates. So for first year, as you know, it's common. And in the second year, you would be traveling abroad to do this program. And there you would be getting specialized and very much concentrated form of knowledge in this program. And there at the second year, you will be doing 36 credits, and six credits would be in the form of summer internship or thesis work, that is practical work, and one credit means 15 hours of teaching there. And so the session would begin sometime in the last week of August. So that is when the session begins there. So before that, you have to seek the admission, as well as you have to arrange for your visa. So that arranging for visa and so that is, and for the arrangement for the necessary other requirements would have to be done by the student. So IITJ role ends when you get an admission there. And so as far as going abroad is concerned, that is one thing. So another thing is like the second semester for this program would begin. So you see that it's a very much concentrated form of sessions you will be having. So your second year is going to be very much busy there. So you have to do a lot of groundwork, lot of preparation for your necessary background, whatever you wish to do in India. So if you do it, you would be better positioned, because there you would be having a very busy time in terms of courses there. And the cost structure, which for the second year at the foreign partner institution, for in this case that is Sunny Albani, will be $25,000 for your tuition. And out of this, $5,000 is the scholarship which is expected for all the students who would be enrolling for this program. So practically it would come to $20,000 for tuition fees. And this will be supplemented by paid work opportunities as per the regulations of that country. You can do, and you can expect some kind of financial assistance in the form of paid work opportunities, and they are quite plenty. That's what our understanding is. That's what the foreign partner institutions have told us, that there are quite the chances of getting the paid work opportunities are very good. And of course, you are free to approach the state governments or some other form of government scholarships if you can. So if you get some kind of many, I think in India, so there may be some, if you get some kind of scholarship from the government, then based on your admission offer, so then you are also free to avail it. And so IITJ students could apply for this program by May 15th. So that is the latest, but it is rolling. You can apply at any time. So it's earlier you apply, the better you are. So if you are firm in your decision, it's better to apply early, start preparation, and seek visa. And so you are better. But the latest deadline is May 15th. But you can apply as early as even January or February. So it's up to you. So once you apply, the outcome may be expected in as little as 2 weeks. So now coming to our second partner institution, that is Brandeis International Business School. This is also one of the well-known schools, and many of our students have got the admission offer from this school. And so it is also a 2-year program. 1 year at IITJ. IITJ offers MBA. Second year is at this school. And this school is offering you 3 choices. And you can choose as per your wish. That is, one is Master's of MS in Business Analytics. Another is MS in Finance. And the third degree is MA in International Economics and Finance. So here you have MSBA, that is MS in Business Analytics is 41 credits, out of which 4 credits is practical work. MS in Finance is 45, and MA in International Economics and Finance is 48 credits. So here 1 credit is equal to 10 hours of teaching. And here you see that Sunny Albani session begins in the last week of August, and here it begins. Here it's a trimester system, and the first trimester, the session is beginning in the mid of June. So here, that's why you have to apply for this process little early. And the fees here is $42,500 for all the 3 programs. And you can compare this fees with the normal fee for these programs. And it is 35% or more reduction to it. So that is another part. Sorry, anything, any question? Okay. So in some cases, here the scholarship may also be expected up to 75% of the fee. And in special cases, if you need, there could be some, you can apply for some need-based scholarship, like if there is some genuine case of some particular needs. And on-campus employment chances are also there here in the case of Brandeis. So here the deadline to apply is 15 January, but it could be, it is advisable to apply as early as possible, and the decision outcome could be expected in as early as 2 weeks. And naturally the students must arrive by early June so that they can join the session by mid-June. And here your basically they see your entire education background and first term performance at IITJ, if it is available. Some kind of video interview is performed, and our students would tell you more about this. And recommendation letters are desirable, and transcripts of undergraduate degree. That is what they see. So any questions so far, if you have anything missing or something? Okay. So our third institute is the George Washington University Business School. And here you have, it is also 2 year program like others. And total 2 years, 1 year at IITJ and 1 year at the foreign university, the George Washington University. And you have two choices for dual degree here. One is MS in Business Analytics and another is MS in Applied Finance. And MS in Business Analytics is 33 credits, MS in Applied Finance is 36 credits, and one credit is here 10 hours of teaching. And so here also the semester begins by last week of August, and more likely on August 31. And the program ends on May 11 as far as semester is concerned, and there may be exams after it. So here the cost structure is, if there are more than 31 students in their entire class there. So from IIT Jodhpur, any number of students can join, but the structure here is cumulatively, if the batch size at the school for a particular program is more than 30, then it would be $35,000 for MSBA and $41,000 for the MSAF program. But if there are 0 to 29 students, if there are less than 30, that is 0 to 29, that the batch size total there is somehow is lesser than 30, then it would be 10% higher than this fees. So $38,500 per student and $45,100 per student for MSAF. And the good thing here is for our students who are going here for being first set of admissions, this condition is not applicable. So even if it is 0 to 29, the fees would be $35,000 and $41,000 for MSBA and MSAF respectively. So this thing is about the cost structure. And the understanding which we have is like the chances of getting more than 30 are very bright. So it's very much likely that the student size is more than 30 always, like as per the based on the last few years. So there is, that is what the situation is. And so here, since the session is beginning in last week of August, So it's advisable to apply as early as possible, and application deadline here is January 15, which could go up to January 31. And if you apply by this date, admission decisions will be communicated by March 1. So these dates are advisable, but if there are some really very much, if you somehow miss, then it could be, it may be considered, but these are what the deadlines are. And of course, the instruction for MSBA will be, this degree program would happen at the GWU campus. And so basically they, what the selection here is, if you are applied through IITJ, they would, your chances of getting admission are very, very bright. And but still they would like to see your readiness for taking this program. So if you're going for MS in Business Analytics or MS in Applied Finance, of course it is expected that you have the basic level of understanding as far as quantitative and statistics courses are concerned. So it is good if you perform good in these courses in your first year at MBA. And in this particular partner university, like, you also need to have a TOEFL score, which is not the case in the case of State University of New York and the Brandeis. So there you don't need to have either GRE, GMAT or TOEFL score. But only in the case of George Washington University, you also need to clear your TOEFL, and your TOEFL score needs to be part of your application. And that should be done by you before you apply. So at the time of, so that is a necessary condition to get an admission offer from them. So, so now, any questions if you have, or?
Sir, actually there are two questions. One is from Ayusha Singh. She is asking that what is the criteria of selection from SME if she wants to pursue dual degree program? What is the criteria, eligibility criteria or selection process?
So basically, for which program she wants to apply?
Ayusha, if you could unmute yourself and speak out.
Sir, I'm interested in Brandeis. So I wanted to know the selection criteria for that.
So for the case of Brandeis, the how it works is, we recommend to the student these kind of guidelines, and we are basically forwarding your application, or you can apply to the Brandeis directly, and we would be all, if and if there is any kind of so if they get in touch with us for your information, then we provide them. So and then there will be video interviews for them. So in so that is how it works.
Okay, thank you, sir.
So sir, there is another question from Srijan Garg. He is asking that whether the tuition fees include all the other charges. So Srijan, by other charges, what do you mean exactly? Like the travel expenses, the living expenses? You can unmute yourself and speak up. Achha, hostel, etc. So sir, he's asking whether the hostel fees and everything are included in the tuition fees.
No. So it is only the tuition fee. For hostel, there is another component, and that would be separate. And also, it may not be guaranteed that you may get the hostel in every partner university. So it depends on the availability there, but chances are good. So for that, it would be separate. It would be different from the tuition fee.
Srijan, does that answer your question? Yeah, Jugal will be coming to that. We'll be having a discussion.
Yeah, so the... after this, yeah. I would be requesting our students who have applied for these programs to give you a perspective on what has what analysis they have gone through, because they must have done a very much rich analysis, and they so you are free to so you will be you are free to get in touch with them and get their perspective about the different aspects of this program, so that we will be connecting. And
right, sir, we'll be doing that. So everyone, we have our batchmates who have applied for, and some have got selected already. So we would like to start with Keshav Agarwal. Keshav, are you there?
Yes. Yes, Shubhadi.
Hi, Keshav. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you. So Keshav, you're a finance enthusiast, right? You have been helping your peers in understanding the critical finance theories and everything. And you have been, for your information, guys, he has been accoladed gold for his excellence in academics in 12th standard. So Keshav, tell me first, how did you, like, how did this achievement help you in achieving your career goals or going forward and cutting through the competition as an MBA aspirant? What would be your insight?
So, to be honest, as far as gold is concerned, it didn't help much except for the bullet point in my CV. But what helped me was the number that I got. So because of the numbers that I've got, I was able to secure a position in DU. And through that, I have developed myself in this position that I am here today. Right?
Okay, great to know. So Keshav, as we can see, you have applied for the MS in finance program in Brandeis, right?
Right.
So why MS in finance?
So I mean, finance is my area of interest, and MS I chose because it provides more in-depth knowledge in finance instead of an MBA. So that's why I chose MSF, to be honest.
So you want to go all in for finance, right?
Yeah, all in for finance.
Okay. Great to know. Thank you, Keshav.
Sure.
Yeah, next we have with us our batchmate Anjana. Hi, Anjana.
Hello, Jared.
Yeah, hope you're doing good and all prepared for tomorrow's exams. As we know, Anjana is a class representative of our batch, and she has a lot of things to manage. And it's very interesting to know how she manages her time and all those responsibilities as a CR. So, talking about the journey so far. So starting from the very beginning, as to now, what made you think about pursuing a dual degree, and what was the thing that was attracting you towards pursuing a dual degree?
Okay, talking about me working as a CR for the past term, it's not really that tough as I expected or imagined. It's just about communication, give no scope for any miscommunication anywhere, and be as transparent as possible. That's it. And talking about MS, I applied for MSF at Brandeis. So talking about my journey, I was looking for finance related options in these three colleges, and I found finance specialization in George Washington University and Brandeis. So I applied for, George Washington University requires TOEFL, and I didn't really have time to give TOEFL because I took decision really a little late to apply. So I opted for Brandeis. So prerequisites for Brandeis is you need to submit your UG transcripts, your UG marks, your first term marks, and an SOP, why you want to choose, why you are interested in Brandeis, and then two recommendation letters. One is from one is from a lecturer from IITJ itself, and another one is from my workplace. So Brandeis has this admission portal where you keep filling all of these, and once you're done with it, I got a call from Brandeis, and after this interview is scheduled, and interview was about 15 to 20 minutes. To talk about my experience, the questions asked were more of personality based. It was they asked about which city am I from, how good team player am I, how is Brandeis helping me to achieve my professional goals. And also they asked me how a team player am I? And last one, like, just she gave me like 20 seconds time and she asked me to tell one sentence about you, describe yourself in 20 seconds. So I felt that was more like a conversation. It was nothing technical, nothing related technical. I think they are judging us based on our marks and transcripts we are already submitting. So interview was more about knowing about us in person. So that was my experience giving the interview. And yeah, I got a call in less than a week. So we have time, till March 15th to submit the first set of fees and accept the offer. Also, during the interview, we even questioned them about any financial aids and on-campus jobs. And they've actually promised that we'll definitely get the chance to work in the campus there. And also, if we apply for financial aids based on our marks, they'll definitely decide and give the financial aid. And that will be depending on the semester wise marks. Like maybe firstly they'll give for one semester and then again they'll look at the semester marks and do something. So,
thank you, Anjana, for a detailed explanation of the admission process, and congratulations on getting shortlisted in Brandeis.
Thank you, sir.
So we have Chandralekha with us. Yeah, thank you, Anjana, again. So we have Chandralekha with us. So Chandralekha, are you there?
Yeah.
Hi, Chandralekha. How are you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you. Chandralekha, as we can see, you are a fresher, right? You are a computer science engineer and you are a fresher. So could you please tell us how has your experience been so far as a fresher in this very rigorous curriculum and this
The starting is always difficult. It depends upon how you manage. You start learning how to manage things. That's what I did. Trust me, the starting was very tough for me, a transition from an engineering fresher to an MBA, which gives you a lot of work, a lot of cases, everything in a very little time. So yeah, you have friends you've got who support you, teachers who encourage you, then now I'm pretty cool. It is like I'm able to manage my things, my time, my courses. It is going pretty good now.
I think the faculty shouldn't hear that we are cool with our courses. You know what I'm trying to say. So Chandra, could you please share your experience with us, like from the very beginning, what motivated you to get into this dual degree program and how you applied, what all happened in between?
I applied for MS in Business Analytics from GWU. From an academic point of view, I am a tech graduate, so I have always been interested in data, analytics, these kind of stuff. So for my managerial skills, the first year, a few specific skills I learned, they are helping me a lot. And I wanted to enhance on my analytics skills, especially with business analytics. I saw the curriculum and I really liked it, especially the electives where I can choose what I want, like supply chain management, sports management. That is what interested me more. But apart from academic point of view, it is like I always wanted to learn and experience a different cultural environment. So that is what actually motivated me to go for an MS in business analytics.
That's great, Chandralekha. Thank you for sharing your experience.
Thank you.
So next we have with us our friend Nagaraju. Hi Nagaraju, how are you doing?
Hi Jalal, I'm good. How are you?
Yeah. So like just to know, like he's part of the sports committee and was one of the coordinators and is a very in sports enthusiast and is also a phenomenal badminton player. So my question for you is, Nagaraju, like what was the reason for you to choose Brandeis among the options that you had for dual degree programs?
Firstly, I can say that the curriculum, which is really, I mean, I found it was a little bit better for me. I can choose which subject I can do. And for example, I can do data management, I can do that. For example, I can do chain management, I can do that. So firstly, I can say that curriculum, and second thing, I was waiting for last 2 years regarding business. I mean, dual degree. I always want to be in US to do my MS, and now I got that offer, so I'm ready for it, I think.
Yeah, thank you, Naga. And also being an active member in sports and getting different awards and recognitions, did it help you get the admission into one of these colleges? Like, did it have an extra added advantage for you?
Yes. I was talking about in my interview there. She was asking me about what is your, I mean, she asked me about my management skills. So I told her what I did in sports, what I did my graduation. These things happened to me. I mean, this thing helped me when my interview happened. So I can say that this helped me.
Yeah. Thank you, Naga.
Thank you.
Manish, are you there? There's a question from SK.
Please.
Yeah, sir, there's a question from SK. He or she is asking that, is there any stay back option after the course in US?
So if you are getting a degree from US, so you would be enjoying the same benefits as any other person, as your counterpart in US. So that is so you would be eligible for the employment there as per the US regulations. So you would be, your degree would be same as any other person in US.
And sir, what if somebody comes back after the course and he or she wants to sit for the placements here in IIT Jodhpur? Will he or she be allowed for that?
Yeah, so yes, so that is he and she would be allowed for sitting in the placement as far as the company allows them. So if they meet the criteria at that point of time, that is possible.
Oh, that is great, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So we are definitely, so if the company is considering them, so definitely we are going to do whatever school can.
Yes, sir. Thank you. So next up is Shubham Rokade. Shubham, how are you? Shubham.
Great, Shubhadeep. I'm great.
Yeah, we just got to know that you suffered a major health breakdown. But guys, just to tell you that this health breakdown didn't stop him. It didn't hinder him from his daily activities, be it academics or extracurriculars. He did it very actively during his tough time. So how are you right now? Have you fully recovered, Shubham?
Yes, Shubhadeep. I'm much better now and back to all my stuff, even more level-headed. Thank you so much.
Nice. Yeah, good to know. So Shubham, tell me, how do you see this global dual degree as a stepping stone in your career?
Well, to begin with, I always saw myself working or pursuing something overseas in my future as an experience and to get some kind of knack what international business culture is like. But of course, not during my MBA. But however, when I researched about this amazing opportunity at SME IITJ has to offer, I started giving more thoughts at it and decided to back this chance really. So I feel very much lucky to be a part of this batch and this concept of dual degree curated so well by IIT Jodhpur. And of course, SME is providing me with such a solid base of management and making me fundamentally strong over my concepts and giving me a chance to even groom and excel in my area of interest in the second year by providing such an international platform. So the MS Finance course from Brandeis International Business School is handcrafted according to today's industry and business needs, which resonates with SME's MBA program as well. The specialized finance concentrations, internship opportunities, a very practical hands-on exposure with a unique pedagogy of learning is what I'm going to get and continue at Brandeis. I'm saying continue because SME is no less in giving me the same. So, and of course, being a bachelor of management in finance itself, this is, I think, the perfect platform for me to top up my skills and knowledge and make myself industry ready and deliver at a larger level. And being a fresher considered by IITJ and Brandeis both, I would be starting my first job at the States if everything goes well. And that itself would be a very big achievement for me at the personal level. Plus the privilege and honor of taking the SME IIT Jodhpur as a B-School brand overseas and making it count is something I'm really, I would be proud and happy for. And with all my fellow dual degree aspirants and mates. I can't wait to establish SMEs Mark on an international scale. And yes, I would be getting a much scenic photography options now at Boston from about my hobby and
taking. Yes. Just to tell you guys, Shubham is a photographer with passion, and we have seen his works, and these are really good. Yeah, Shubham. So, how are you looking at it? Like, when you are in state, you will be doing some photography and everything. So that should go side by side, right?
That's a much bigger upgrade for me. I would have never thought about it particularly, but I would be getting much scenic photography options now at Boston, just from taking photographs in Mumbai and nearby cities in Maharashtra, now to shooting a whole new city overseas. It just makes me immensely happy, Jyoti. I'm very grateful.
Yeah, even we are happy for you. We'll be able to see those photos. Thank you, Shubham. Thank you for your answer. Yeah.
Yeah, next we have with us Suyesh Srivastava. Hi, Suyesh, and thank you for joining today's session.
Hi, Gerald. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, like, we knew Suyesh since the day one, and we understood like he was very serious about these dual degree programs since the day one. So what was that opportunity or driving force that made you, you know, take up this decision?
So one of the key decisions for me to join SMEIT Jodhpur was this option of dual degree. So as most of us who joined with me, they knew that, you know, this was a starting point of our discussion, that I'll be, you know, we had a like-minded set of classmates. So we knew that, okay, we have to go on and opt for dual degree. So since then I was interested, and now we are finally getting somewhere and making a headway in the dual degree thing. So I'm going for MSBA in George Washington University. I'm planning to do that. And for that, as Manisha said, we have to give TOEFL exam and everything. So I just gave my TOEFL in the first week of January. I cleared the cutoff. I've applied. They have received my application and everything. And now it's there's this WES process which is going on right now. So my transcript from my engineering college, so that will be electronically mailed it to the GW University. So that process is being going on. But yeah, dual degree was one of the major things which made me go for SMEIIT Jodhpur over various options which I had, including other IITs and IIMs. So yeah.
Very so guys, he's being very humble because he said he had cleared the cutoff. He actually scored 105 out of 120. So Suresh, tell me one thing. How was your, how did you prepare yourself for the TOEFL exam? Like, what extra did you have to do for that?
I think the CAT preparation really helped, because I knew that the case studies which we have been going through in our regular classes and regular courses, so they are around 20 or 30 pages long. So going through the case studies week in, week out, so I knew that, okay, I can handle the reading comprehension. The main thing which boiled down to, and which I thought, okay, might be a good challenge, was the speaking part, because in 30 or 40 seconds, you have to listen to a conversation and, you know, interpret in your own way and present it. So within the very short span of time, they just give you 20 seconds. You have to muster up whatever you can through the conversation and, you know, just spit it out there. So that was the challenging part, which I thought. But yeah, and with a little practice and everything, just after the classes were done, I used to find, you know, take out time from around 30 minutes or so from my schedule. And yeah, so that's how I prepared for the listening part. For the rest of the part, I was pretty much okay.
Yeah, also Suyesh has a very rich industry, IT industry experience before joining SME. So I hope, like, Suyesh, like, you'll be able to capitalize the experience that you have, and also matching with the curriculum, I hope it'll help you gain more knowledge and help way.
One of the requirements for this MSBA courses in GW is that you need to have a decent amount of work ex. So I have worked in Infosys for around 4 years. So I have also done my engineering in information technology. So I have a little bit of tech background, and I have the technical inclination, and the curriculum in GW University I really found interesting, and being in DC itself, as Shivam said, he has many things to do there. So yeah, I'm also looking forward to do many things in DC. I have a couple of friends in my college friends in DC, so I'm planning to meet them as well. So yeah, that's about it. So I believe my background in IT and Infosys will help me in, you know, starting a career or something there. So really looking forward and excited for that part.
Yeah. Thank you, Suyesh.
Thank you, Gerald. Thank you, Shivali.
Yeah, thank you, Suyesh. So next up is Venu. Venu, you have applied for Brandeis, right? So there are three big names, Brandeis, George Washington University, and Sunny Albany. So why exactly Brandeis?
First thing is, the requirement for GW is right, means you should have total score. So I didn't have the time, or I didn't plan to write. I didn't plan accordingly so that I could apply by Jan 15. So I was planning to apply for MSBA program to go with my manager skills to acquire some technical analysis data, so that will help me in the future. So that's why MSBA, and since Sunny Albany is not offering MSBA, I chose Brandeis over it. And also, as far as Brandeis is concerned, the location advantage, as everyone knows, that's in Boston, where there are many companies, as well as innovation and healthcare startups are going on there. As well as in Brandeis University particularly, there is for health for startups, and there is a Brandeis Maker Lab and some entrepreneurship clubs there. And during my research about Brandeis University particularly, I've gone through an article where two MSBA and MBA students have started a startup collaborating with each other. And also the curriculum, which is very practically hands-on experience, as well as helping us to do some internship as part of the program, 12 months as a academic program, and 4 months mandatory internship for project. Brandeis.
Right, Venu, very well said. So Venu, tell me one thing, how would you going to manage your financial constraints, and what is your plan ahead for that?
Plan, currently I'm applying for scholarships. As many of them told, when I asked them during the interview, they told that they will be providing scholarships with some requirements, with some conditions. So currently I'm applying for government scholarships, as well as applying for educational loans, and some of it through my personal finance. And hopefully I will do well there and I'll get the scholarships from the university as well.
Yeah, definitely, Venu. Very all the best to you. Hope you get your scholarships and everything. Thank you, Venu. Thank you for your answer.
Yeah, next we have with us Zwaras Hamid. Yeah. Hi, Zwaras, welcome.
Hello, how are you, Gerald?
Yeah, I'm good. I hope you're doing good too.
Yeah, I'm also doing good.
So, Zwaras has actually applied to two different B schools. And could you just share with us your experience on what was the differences in the admission process on both these schools? And what was your intention behind applying to different B schools?
Okay, so at first I applied to Brandeis University, but unfortunately I was rejected. But that's not bad. I got to learn the process, and also I made some rectifications, and I got to learn a lot from that. But there's a difference between Brandeis and GWU. In GWU, we have to do a VES evaluation, and right now I'm in that process, and I think that I'll get through. I actually hope that I get through GWU and join Suyash with me there.
Yeah, that's good to hear. We also hope that you clear GWU and join Suyash on his journey there.
Yes, we actually hope that too.
Looking forward to it, Zaris.
Yeah, thank you, Zaris.
So I think, Manish sir, you can tell us about few of the opportunities that we may be having in the campus if we go on there.
Yeah, so actually, it is to my mind, one of the best thing about this is you are getting 2 degrees in the same time. So in 2 years, you are earning 2 degrees. And the program both at IITJ and at the Foreign University are very much concentrated and the crisp. So you have to, it will definitely teach you, it will definitely give you an experience to face your corporate life apart from the knowledge you would be earning and definitely the degrees you are earning. So it will prepare you for your future. It will tell you how to work hard, and I'm sure with your energy and with your vision, you would be enjoying it, because this is a time to work very hard, and there is no big pleasure other than working hard. So if you are very much directed towards your goal, it definitely, you know, you would enjoy it and it will be a memorable experience. No? Like that is what I can share with you from my experience, because and it will be a memorable experience and the time flies away. No? Time flies very fast. So if if you are comfortable that about the cost and these factors, but I think it's a golden opportunity because you are learning complementary skills and you are at the right age. And since you have taken, you have decided or you are going to decide to join MBA, then you have already taken a break from your work. And then, so why not to utilize it maximum, no? Make the best utilization of time. Time is very, very precious. Make as best, these degrees you may not earn in future again. No, it will, you may be little aged, you may be married by time. And so these things, so like if I were you, I sometimes think that why this opportunity I didn't get at my age, because so that is one thing. And secondly, it may also be a gateway to US experience. So if you are doing a degree from US, you may be, you definitely or very good chances that you may be absorbed in US job somewhere. So it will give you a US experience. So other, if you compare, the another advantage which I see is the fact that relaxed admission. So if you go for GRE and GMAT, because why they are relaxing is not for something, but the only reason they are relaxing is because of your admission to IITJ, your clearing of CAT, your admission in IITJ, your going for courses of IITJ is a bigger proof that you are ready to take those programs. And some programs are also taking your video interview and all, just to see that yes, you are there, just to confirm what is their understanding about you. So that is only for your for their double confirmation, but 99% you are going to be in. So based on our talks with them, you know? So it's a, you know, like if you are getting good admission there, admission to find out admission details and all is a big process, takes your time. So if you invest 1 year for that, so that 1 year is also very costly. So here you are directly on the goal, getting admission. And I very much appreciate you can see that how Suyash is determined to go for particular university. He cleared TOEFL amidst his MBA program going on. So I am sure that he must have properly analyzed the value which GW is offering. And in other partner university, you don't have to clear TOEFL also. So that way, so it will give you some, so this is what I think, the utilization of your time, earning complementary skills, MS degree plus MBA. Because MBA, to my mind, if it is coupled with MS, nothing like that. And you are eligible for two streams also. Like one thing is your no job, you have to be multi-skilled, holistic learning is required. So that is, and then you can become core manager plus technical, core technical too, if you have interest. So, I have some friends. So sometimes they have feel that going for MBA has sometimes, technical experience, they have, the MBA has overshadowed their technical background. But if you are if you are going for this program, you are still very much grounded in your roots. So if you are technical in your undergraduate, and so you are further enhancing that part, and plus you are learning more skills in MBA. So I think it's a very great opportunity. And second thing is you are having some relaxation in fees also. So biggest advantage is the time part. That is what appeals to me most. And to my mind, I have not seen this kind of program in any other part of the any other schools like that way, and or as good as schools as IIT. And IIT Jodhpur has a great future. So by the time you will be passing out, it could be one of the even more, the sheen will be even more. So rest you all know better than me, I think. So that's what my thought. thoughts are for your consideration.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for answering. So, guys, Suya, Shubham, Chandra, Anjana, all of you, Venu. So, guys, tell me, how did our faculties help you? Like, you know that there are these things, this letter of recommendation and everything you need help with. So, how our faculties helped you, and how did you like manage to do these things along with your studies and everything?
So I think for me, Mayank sir was there. So another reason for me to join SME was Professor Mayank. I think he will be there in the meeting. So I've been in touch with him since March, I guess, last year, March. So I asked him to write my letter of recommendation, and he was very kind enough to write it and, you know, support me and guide me as well. Even Manish sir as well. I was behind him for a long time. Okay, sir, I need to meet you in the campus. And when he told me that he was in the campus, so I rushed to meet him. And then I asked him regarding the scope and everything, and should I go on. So I had a good chat with Manish sir as well for around half an hour. And he was very kind enough to stroll around with me and give me guidance. So Manish sir and Mayank sir were there. And also then another, like in GW, you have to write two letters of recommendation. You have to get two LORs. So another professor we have is Professor Sankar Pratap. So he has done his PhD as well as MBA from IIM Calcutta. And he was very kind enough to, you know, guide me as well. He was the one who checked my statement of purpose. So earlier when I gave him the statement of purpose to check, then he pointed out some mistakes which could be, you know, rectified and corrected. And so faculties have been really good. And also we have a marketing professor, Anuj Pal sir. So Anuj sir has also not done dual degree, but he has done the exchange program in Germany. So I knew that he would be the person who would be having some experience. So I approached him as well. And then we also had a chat for around 45 minutes. So one of the things which he told me was that we are at that stage of in our life, we don't have much liabilities and, you know, responsibilities. We're not married. We don't have any, you know, financial obligations and many other things. So this is the time to take the risk and, you know, plunge towards these things. So he was very positive about this. So he said, in my personal opinion, you should go for it. He said that I didn't have the option to go for dual degree, only the exchange program. But he suggested that, you know, if you are getting this opportunity to go for dual degree, we should, you know, just go ahead with it. Because we are at that stage of our life where we can afford to take the risk. So he contrasted his stage that he is married, he has kids and everything. So it will be difficult for him if he plans to do something sort of similar thing in his professional career. But he said, since we are students, so, you know, we can charter on this path and, you know, take on this thing. So faculties have been all around. We have got 17 faculties on campus, and each and every one is very approachable. That's just humbling to talk and interact with them regarding anything, be it course or be it anything under the sun. So yeah, that's my personal experience.
That's great, Shweesh. So Shubham, could you please tell your experience with the whole process, like how it has been for you?
Definitely, Shubham. Because I would really thank Manish sir, because like since day one, he was very keen in engaging and solving all our doubts. Because being a dual degree program and not being really aware of international universities per se, so it was really helpful for them to you know, point out small issues and, you know, responding to all the mails very promptly, talking to the international universities, reverting to us, and keeping us updated per se. So it was really kind of them to, and I have such a, we are actually very lucky to have such a support from his side. And of course, talking about the recommendation, the letter of recommendations, I would really, really would like to thank Preeti ma'am for providing me the same. And it was, I think it plays a major role in our selection and the faculties over there to judge what kind of candidate are we. So it was really kind of Preeti ma'am and Manish sir both to help me immensely go through the Brandeis and get me selected over there. I'm really grateful to both of them. And of course, the support from the college and this whole concept of dual degree, basically, as I earlier said, it's been really wonderful.
That is great to know, Shivam. Thank you. So we have Professor Abhishek Narayan Singh with us. He is a faculty of the area of business analytics. So, sir, I have always been asking this question to you, that cybersecurity course, how is it going to help us and how is it going to be a thing for the future? So, sir, could you please share your insights on the same?
Yes, Shubhadeep. Yeah, see, cybersecurity is one of the very emerging areas, right? And if you see the Gartner's top 10 technology trends for 2021, right? Cybersecurity mesh is one of them, right? Now, since the every field of our life, every walk of our life is one or the other way is being digitized, right? In a day, just imagine the kind of dealings that we do with our digital world, be it sending money to somebody, ordering your food, booking a ticket, ordering something on e-commerce platform, whatever, right? Planning your trip. We are dealing with the digital technologies, and more the dependence of our life for any kind of thing that we do as an individual or as an organization for businesses. The dependence on different kinds of digital mediums are increasing day by day. And we have seen how many folds it has increased during the last few months because of this pandemic. So this pandemic actually has fast forwarded the digital adoption and the use of the digital technologies for all of us. What it would have taken, let's say, 7 to 8 years, we have traveled that distance in 7 to 8 months, right? Now, since everything is getting digitized, right, for us as an individual or for businesses, there are emerging threats also, right? So more and more you are dealing with technologies or digital mediums, there are threats which are increasing and expanding, and this threat landscape is evolving day by day. Now, to counter this, we have different kinds of cybersecurity techniques, methods, risk analysis mechanisms, network security techniques, and so on and so forth, right? Be it any kind of business that you are in, right? You are dealing with these kinds of threats. Now, if you see different kinds of reports which are coming from the Gartner or Ernst & Young or Symantec or so many other agencies into this area, they are seeing that there is a dearth of experts into this domain who understand information security, cybersecurity, risk analysis, and so on and so forth. So there is a huge demand and potential into this domain. And Sunny Albani actually offers you the program which trains you into this cybersecurity. There are various certifications, there are various programs that you can do to equip yourself or to make yourself familiar with these kinds of advanced techniques. And if you see the Sunny's program, it is more on digital forensics and cybersecurity and these things. So be assured that this field is evolving, right? Since the new kinds of adoption of digital technologies are evolving, we are dealing with new kinds of techniques in terms of different kinds of business processes that are being conducted by the organizations. And so is the threat, so is the challenges in terms of maintaining the security and integrity of different kinds of systems that these organizations use, right? So overall, I would say cybersecurity is going to be an emerging field. And there are various facets of it. If you see from the physical security to data protection, network security, and so on and so forth, application level security. So there are various levels and the various layers of cybersecurity. If you have interest, that's a very emerging field. And there are enough opportunities into that area, I would say. Yes.
Thank you, sir. That is really comprehensive and everything. Thank you so much for answering that, sir. So guys, if you have any question, everybody is there. You can shoot your question right now.
Just to inform to all the applicants here or people who are listening to this or will listen to this on YouTube later on, we as a school, we are also looking for more partners across the globe. And there are various talks going on various levels with business schools in Europe, Australia, and other parts of the world also, to have these kinds of international collaborations. And IIT being a brand itself, we have various partners for different kinds of engineering programs already with us. Now we are trying to expand this horizon to the business school of our SME as well. And so this is one information. And then the different kinds of opportunities that you get, right? Once you have done this, and Professor Manish has already talked about it, MS along with MBA, it opens up your scope. It opens up the different kinds of opportunities for all of you, right? So that has its unique value. And of course, the different kinds of, I would say the relaxations in terms of the GRE or TOEFL are different kinds of exams that you have to do, or the relaxation in terms of the fees is an added advantage for all of you. So this is one of the, if I can use unique propositions that SME has, it won't be too much to claim, right? So that's a bit of information that I would like to share. Yes, and if you have any more questions on this, just feel free to write to us any point of time. We would like to answer your queries on that. Yes.
Yes, sir, definitely. We are very active on all the social media handles, and we would really love to answer all those questions. So guys, just for as a general feedback, you guys are attending our webinars for last couple of weeks, I would say. So how has been your experience with our webinars? If you could speak up, Ayusha, Sunandita, Pratik, Ajinka, Aditya, anybody, if anybody wants to speak up, you can unmute yourself and say.
Yeah, so hello everyone, this is Ayusha. So I attended last two sessions, including this one and the previous one, and I found it very informative, especially this one, because I had a lot of query regarding this dual program. And actually, this is the first time I've heard this about the program, and it feels really exciting. So yeah, I'm looking forward for this program. Thank you.
Thank you, Ayusha. Thank you for sharing your thoughts. Anybody else? Sunandita, Harish, Paddy, Yashashvi, Apoor, Jugal. You can put it in the chat box as well.
Hello, Harish. Yeah. I am Harish here. So from the day one when I've been seeing the Exodium series, we are not just me, I think many of them are just addicted to your programs right now. We are waiting more and more for these programs. But one thing I want to mention is that I'm looking for a mention of target audience. Like if it is there, it would be much more better, as I feel. And overall, I'm seeing much more interactive sessions day by day. And coming to the Exodium Series 1, till all the symposiums and today's dual degree, I'm looking more and they are more and more interactive. And very much a lot of thanks to everyone who are active in Facebook, WhatsApp, as well as Telegram channels. They are providing a good insight for us. And we are really looking forward to join you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Harish.
Thanks, Harish, for your nice words. And I must say, all the credit for all this good job goes to our student team. The faces that you are seeing on your screen and the faces behind it, all the credit goes to the entire team of the wonderful set of students that we have at SME, right? So entire credit to the team of students. Yes. Are any more topics on which you want us to give you a relevant set of information if you are looking for? So that you can always send us in the emails, or you can mention it on the WhatsApp or the Telegram groups that we have created. We would be very happy to offer you information if something is missing or something that is specifically you are looking at. And let me just tell you, if you have received our mails today, that we are coming up with a unique another set of series of master classes, right? So which we are going to start very soon, from the very next week, wherein we as faculty members at SME, we are coming and talking to you and giving you a flavor of what is our another unique offering, that is the Tech MBA, how it is going to be and what is how it is different from the normal MBA program, right? So stay tuned, and I'm happy to hear that you have got some addiction with the kind of webinar series that we have got. Although we have been looking for more such participation from your side, so if you can just help us in propagating this word, And if you have found it useful, that will help us to reach out to more such candidates. And looking forward to having your participation and interaction in the masterclass as well. Right, so stay tuned. There will be something more exciting coming to you very soon.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, yes.
Sorry to disturb, sir. I had a question. Like, I have a plan of going into further research program and then eventually convert into a faculty. So, how will this dual degree help me in that? Like, will it be a drawback? Like, I will have MS as well as MBA. So, won't that be a drawback, or will it benefit me in my further goals?
Surely it won't be a drawback, Ayusha. Why it will be a drawback, right? So see, you will get 1 year's experience at IIT, right? So you can you will be well versed of the system at and the research activities, since you are inclined towards the research of one particular set of, let's say, country or the kind of standard of organizations, right? And we have a wonderful set of faculty members who are very active in terms of publishing research in high quality journals and so on. And then as an add-on, when you go to any of the three universities that we have right now, or the other universities that we'll be adding to our kitty soon, this will give you another level of experience as well, right? So there you can actually compare, contrast, and you can collaborate with different kinds of researchers across different universities, right? You can see that what kind of research they are doing. If you have that that perspective, that angle, and if you wish to pursue that you are saying, so that will only broaden up your canvas and horizon, right, to explore more such opportunities. And these universities, as you must be aware, that these are the best of the best places, right? So this will only going to add up to your overall skill sets or the scope of the research, I would say, right? So it's a wonderful option if you're looking for dual degree, and also if you're looking at the research per se. So that is going to add immensely, I would say. Yes.
Professor Abhishek, if I can add something.
Yes, Prof. Yes. Let me just introduce Professor Sankal Pratap. You have heard the name here. He is a senior faculty here in the area of entrepreneurship. Yes, sir, please.
Yes. So this query was from Sujay, is it?
Ayusha.
Ayusha. Okay. Yes, Ayesha. In fact, just to kind of further elaborate and reconfirm what Professor Abhishek was saying, if your interest is in one of your interests, of course, you know, these things keep changing, and one should always be open-minded about where our experiences will take us. But if one of your interests is to go for research in the future, possibly in the field of management, I suppose. A dual degree, as Professor Abhishek was saying, will be actually a very good option, and I'll tell you why. In India, the IITs are the hotbed of research. This is where the government of India provides all the resources that are required to carry out research, which is integrated with the context, with the ground realities of the country. So the expectation is that within IIT, I as a faculty, I carry out research which is going to be useful to our country. It could be of any sector, of course, but something which is useful and something which is not just academic. And this is a very fundamental difference between the research that gets carried out at most of the places, which essentially is from library to library. You do a literature review, you collect some data, and what you prepare again goes back to library as your thesis, and you get a PhD, but nothing gets done. But that is not the case in IIT. So if somebody like you comes here and goes on dual degree, what you will have the option of, but you will have to be very alert and on the ball from day one, that you will be able to meet scholars on the IIT campus and see what kind of research they are doing, right? And then when you go for your dual degree, you will be able to meet an entirely different kind. It will be an entirely different world. So overseas, the kind of places that Professor Manish has spoken about, and we will hopefully add more possibilities by the time some of you join us, those places are
better than us in terms of the methods. In terms of methods, they are a little more advanced. The training that they get is better in methods. But when it comes to doing contextual work for our country, of course, the field work and all the work has to happen in India. So you will be able to make a choice. One of the possible choices is that you come back to India, you do your research in India with an advisory committee. Every research scholar has to have an advisory committee, right? You have an advisory committee, which is a combination of a faculty whom you met overseas based on your interest, but you do the work in India because that is where your strength really lies, because you understand the context, you know the language, you have a feel for certain things. So so this dual degree can actually help you. You can take some methods courses in anticipation of the work that you want to do, because they are stronger in methods. So you take those courses, and they are so free. They are, in fact, even IITJ has built-in systems where you can freely take courses from other departments, and that's a strength of it. So that is a possibility. When I heard your question, I was just thinking, if only I had such an opportunity when I was at your age. So yes, that so this question itself got me excited. So I thought I'll jump in and provide my two bits to your question. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you a lot, sir, for the insight.
Yeah, we are good to go. We can wrap up, I guess.
And just to give a last bit of information, that what further we are planning, that we are planning to bring all these three partners that we have currently, right? So Brandeis and Sunny Albani and the third one, George Washington University, we are trying to bring them on board to give more such information on these programs as well. So we will have more such sessions on the dual degree as and when we hear from all the partner universities, and we will be inviting them for the sessions and the things that they have to offer to you guys, and what will be the opportunities like and the life in those campuses. So stay tuned. We will be having more such sessions on the dual degree opportunities along with our global partner universities, right? So we'll have more such sessions as we go along too. Yes, so there are no more other questions. Probably we can wrap up. Yes, thank you very much, all of you, for the participation.